Mo Farah is the most successful British track and field athlete in modern Olympic Games history. In 2012 and 2016, Farah won both the 5,000 meters and the 10,000 meters. This feat made him the second athlete in modern Olympic Games history to accomplish this historic double. Since placing second in the 10,000 meter final in 2011, Farah would go on to win 10 consecutive global final championships. On the track, Farah primarily focused on the 5K and the 10K. But in 2017, Farah retired from track and made the dramatic announcement that he would exclusively be focusing on the marathon. In this video, we'll analyze Mo Farah's future potential in the marathon, and make sure to stick around until the end of the video when I predict Farah's future marathon times. And if you love running and appreciate short shorts, hit that subscribe button for more great running content. After his retirement from the track in 2017, Farah quickly began to show impressive form in the marathon. On April 22, 2018, Farah placed third in the London Marathon with a time of 2 hours, 6 minutes, and 22 seconds. This time broke the previous British record by an impressive 51 seconds, and it also lowered his own personal best by over a minute. Later that year, on October 7, 2018, Farah won the Chicago Marathon by running a time of 2 hours, 5 minutes, and 11 seconds. This time made Farah the fifth fastest runner in Chicago Marathon history, and also broke the previous European Marathon record by 37 seconds. Farah's success in the marathon is the combination of intense strength training, rigorous mental preparation, and newly developed stride enhancement. So how will Mo Farah favor over the marathon distance in the future? Let's take a look. On the track, Farah had the ability to hang with any runner in the world, then outkick them over the last 100 meters. Currently, it appears that he is using a similar tactic in the marathon, although he's not just attacking over the last 100 meters, but rather the last mile or two. In the 2018 Chicago Marathon, Farah ran with Mozanet Gebremu of Ethiopia for over 24 miles, and over the last 2 miles, Farah showcased supreme strength and outlasted his Ethiopian rival. This strength comes from Mo Farah's highly detailed workout routines. For his marathon preparation, Farah runs anywhere from 100 to 135 miles per week. Additionally, Farah spends many months training in Ethiopia at high altitude. This high altitude training increases the body's production of both hemoglobin and red blood cells since there is less oxygen in the surrounding atmosphere. Many marathoners train at high altitudes, but Farah believes this is essential to success in the marathon. Since switching to the marathon, Farah has also made efforts to alter his stride pattern in order to become more efficient. If you compare Mo Farah's stride to Eliud Kipchoge of Kenya, it's quite apparent that Kipchoge's stride is more efficient. Because Farah understands that the marathon is a race of endurance and attrition, he has made efforts to maximize his running efficiency. One important change to Mo Farah's running form concerns his arms. During his days of complete domination on the track, Farah frequently had extremely exaggerated arm carriage. Alberto Salazar, his former coach, often asked Farah to control his arms when he ran, as his leading hands would commonly raise above his shoulder line. This change would give Farah better efficiency and a better chance at finishing a marathon fast. Another crucial change to Farah's form is the timing of his arms and legs. With such an exaggerated arm swing, Farah would often come close to overstriding. This overstride most commonly presented itself with his front foot landing too far in front of his body, which would leave his trail leg too far behind his center of mass. With better timing of his arms and legs, overstriding will hopefully be eliminated, resulting in higher efficiency during races. In order to predict Mo Farah's future in the marathon, it's also important to understand the type of runner that Mo Farah is. Unlike many of his athletic counterparts, Farah never focused on running world records. Rather, he focused on winning championship races. Indeed, this mentality gave him many championship medals, but his personal records likely suffered because of it. For the marathon, however, this mindset may have the exact opposite effect, resulting in much faster performances. And this may be true for one reason: Eliud Kipchoge. If Farah aims to achieve marathon greatness, he will have to compete with the monumental task of running with Eliud Kipchoge, who has proven himself to be the greatest marathoner in history. Although this is a tall task, Farah has proven himself over and over again on the track, and although he hasn't beaten Kipchoge in the marathon, he is a great marathoner to chase after. With all this information in mind, perhaps we can make an educated guess on what Mo Farah will eventually be able to run in the marathon. Given that Farah has natural speed and natural strength, I think that his marathon future is very bright indeed. I predict that Mo Farah will one day run a marathon in 2 hours and 3 minutes flat, and I think this will happen this year in 2019. Now it's your turn. Let me know what you think. Do you agree? Do you disagree? I would love to know all of your thoughts down there in the comments. Thanks for watching, everyone. Feel free to like and subscribe, comment down below, ring the bell for more notifications, and above all else, keep on running. Thanks, and I'll catch you in the next video.